This is the costume. This is the outfit. It's different. I mean, we're changing things up.
Yeah, true.
Kim Barrett did an incredible job, and when you first wear it, it's like, oh, okay, here we are. I better savor this moment. And it is a surreal thing when you see yourself embodying something that's meant so much to you. But there is a really interesting thing about it because it doesn't belong to you. You very, very quickly realize that it's not you. It isn't you in the suit. It is a symbol. It's just a pure symbol.
I took the idea of Peter Parker creating the spider costume inside the computer, and also the idea of what would happen if there was a gigantic blast of wind and it flew a giant spider web onto a person's body. How would the spider web wrap across the form of a person and create a kind of a pattern?
We were trying to create a suit that felt somewhat legitimate in terms of this kid could make it, and we spent some time developing the ideas behind that.
We had to believe that Peter Parker actually constructed the suit himself. So things like sunglasses, lenses, and shoes, and elements like that.
Well, I was thinking, how would a kid make a suit? Well, he'd probably take tennis shoes and cut the bottoms of them and use that as the pads of the shoes. I mean, if he's making his own suit, who wouldn't do that? It seems a logical thing to do.
I knew that we had to keep it streamlined and keep the silhouette simple. So I looked for shoes that, you know, kept the shape of the foot but still could support it and was still strong, and it came down to basically a track and field shoe. We looked at heaps and heaps and heaps of shoes, and these for the podiatrist, for him, and for us came up, like, I mean, that's really great. So we chose that one, and then we worked on it, pulling it apart, incorporating it into the suit, kind of building it into a boot almost.